Hey guys, welcome to my channel. So in this video we're going to be seeing another empty product mini reviews sort of a video, what's in my trash sort of a video. If you like these type of videos, then please keep on watching, and before which, please take a moment to hit the red color subscribe button right underneath this video and also hit the bell notification so that you get notified every single time I upload. Now let's get started. Now I've collected these empties over the past few months. I would say I have some makeup, I have loads of skincare, body care and hair care as well. And if you want to know what these products are, my thoughts, my mini reviews on these products, then continue watching. Now let's get started with the body products first. The first thing that we're going to be talking about is the shower gel category. I have like three shower gels to show you guys. The first one is this Nivea shower gel lemon and oil. This smelled great, this smelled very refreshing. It cleansed my skin really, really well. I really like the shower gel. However, currently I'm not going to repurchase this because I have like boatloads of Bath & Body Works shower gels that I got on a buy two get two offer. So at the moment, I'm not planning to repurchase any of these shower gels. So that's the first one. I'm going to put this in my trash bag here. And the second one and the third one, both are from Bath & Body Works. I got the mini sizes. The first one is called 1000 Wishes. I actually got... I think this one I got the full size bottle as well. One of these I got the full size bottle. Both of these I really like the fragrance. Oh my god, this smells like so fruity. I like fruity fragrances, and if you take, it's enough if you take like a teeny tiny amount of these shower gels, it's gonna go a very long way. I really like these, and these retail for about ₹495 each, and these are really, really great, and it lasts for a very, very long time. Moving on to body lotion category, I emptied out only this one. This is the Nivea Coco Nourish 48 hour deep moisture care body lotion. This is a very great one. I keep going back to this quite often once I get bored with other body lotions. Once I, you know, stop experimenting with other body lotions, I really like to go back to this one. It's a very, very nice deep nourishing body lotion, especially that we are transitioning into winters currently. This is going to be a great one because it's very nice and thick, and it's kind of very nice and nourishing to your body. So this is a great, great body lotion, and it comes with a pump. It's a 400 ml bottle. Now moving on to deos. I actually forgot to mention one bath product, which is this one. This is the Jeva coffee scrub. This is called the Jeva coffee body scrub with coconut and argan. This is a 50 gram tub. This is a beautiful scrub. I like my body scrubs to be nice and gritty so that it just scrubs my body so well, exfoliates it so well, especially right before I shave my body. I like to go in with scrubs, scrub my body and then shave it. So this is a very nice one. It's a very nice affordable one. I guess it retails for about $225. Yeah, it retails for about $225, and it's a very nice body scrub in my opinion. I really, really like it. Once my other body scrubs are over and once this comes back in stock, I would definitely go ahead and repurchase that. I'm sorry about that thudding noise because I'm just dropping the products into my trash bag. Now moving on to body deodorants. This is the one that I always use. I've emptied out two of these. This is called the Nivea Whitening Smooth Skin Deodorant 48 Hour Protection. This is the deodorant that me and my sister uses. Obviously we use separate bottles, and this is a very nice deodorant. It controls the body odor so well. It does not give a very nice smell or anything. You would have to top it off with a perfume or something, but this controls the body odor really, really well. It kind of stays, it controls the body odor for about 24 hours at least. After that I anyway shower. So this is something really, really great, and I keep going back to this. I keep repurchasing this, and this is the only deodorant that I ever use. This and Rexona one I really, really love. I've showed the Rexona one in my other empties, I guess. Now moving on to the hair care products, I have two conditioners, and I actually emptied out the Herbal Essence Cucumber shampoo thing that's in my shower currently. I forgot to put it inside this bag. I'll pop a picture right here. It's a very nice shampoo. Herbal Essence is my favorite brand in shampoos and conditioners, and recently I started trying out other conditioners as well. This is something that I emptied out quite a long time back. This is the tea tree conditioner from Mama Earth. It's a very okay-ish conditioner, nothing great. It's just okay. There are far better conditioners. Now coming to the conditioner I actually like, this is the Tresemme conditioner. It's the keratin smooth variant and it has argan oil. This makes my hair very, very soft. This is not the conditioner that I use today, but I really, really like this. I have a full size bottle in my bathroom as well that I keep using every now and then. It's a very nice conditioner. The only thing is that I hate the packaging of this. It's very difficult to get the product out of the packaging. You have to like open this, scoop out the conditioner and use it. I hate the packaging. Apart from that, it's a very nice, beautiful conditioner that makes my hair nice and it controls the frizz to a great extent. And this is something that I got free with my purchase or something. This is the Palmer's Natural Fusions Micellar Rose Water Cleanser. This is not that great. I don't feel that it cleanses my hair that well because I have this weird thing that if something does not lather up, it's not cleansing my hair properly. That's a weird thing, but you know, I just like my shampoos to kind of lather a little bit so that I get that squeaky clean feeling. This does not do that. It's a very okay, below average shampoo. And coming to the hair serums that I hate. This is something that I hate. This does nothing to my hair. It just sits on top of my hair and it does absolutely nothing. This is the L'Oreal Total Repair Smoothening and Repairing Serum. And it says it has ceramide and UV filter. This is like very bad. It does not control the frizz. It does not nourish my hair. It does nothing. It just sits like a layer on top of my hair and it does nothing. I don't know why I have two bottles. This one's empty, but this one is like half full. But I'm throwing this away because I just cannot stand it. I cannot figure out a way to use it. So I'm just gonna throw this away. I do not like this. I do not recommend that serum as well. Now moving on to the skincare items, I'm going to be talking about this aloe vera gel. I'm sorry, the lid kind of, I misplaced the lid somewhere, but this is the Body Cupid aloe vera gel. It's a very nice aloe vera gel, but now currently I'm using the WOW one. I switch between the WOW one and the Body Cupid one. Both of them are really, really nice. I like using aloe vera gels whenever I feel really tired and I need, for example, if I used a really stripping face mask that has clay or charcoal, or when I use a chemical exfoliator, I like to use an aloe vera gel to just calm my skin down. Anytime I want to calm my skin down, I like to go in with aloe vera gel. I use it on my face. This is something that's very, very nice. You get a huge quantity. I like this one and the WOW one as well. I'm sorry that the crows are like going crazy, but anyways, this is a very nice one. That's what I wanted to say. And now let's move on to other skincare items. Coming to face washes, I'm a face wash addict, you guys. I buy like 3 to 4 face washes and I keep switching up these face washes and I try to incorporate all of them in my routine. I use one in the morning, one in the night. I use a salicylic acid every other day, salicylic acid based face wash and stuff like that. I really like face washes. Now I have two face washes, no, three I have. This one is like half full. I don't like this much. It's kind of goopy and gummy. This is from Roop Mantra and this is the mixed fruit face wash. It's a very old face wash, so I'm just throwing that away. I have a full review on these Roop Mantra face washes, I guess, and I mentioned that that's my favorite variant, but it's not. I like the cucumber one far better. I don't like that. And coming to my holy grail face wash, this is the Lotus Neem face wash and it says it has neem and clove purifying face wash. This is a very nice face wash. I think it has sodium lauryl sulfate. Yeah, it does have sodium lauryl sulfate, SLS, but this is very nice, you guys. It's not that stripping on my skin. It's a very nice face wash. Coming to my most favorite face wash, this is something that I discovered after watching Shalini Srivastava's top 20 face washes video. I love this. This is the Mom's Co Natural Vita Rich face wash. It has vitamin C, B3, B5, hyaluronic acid, blah blah blah. This comes with a pump. First of all, it's a very nice packaging. I love using face washes that have pumps because it's very easy to disperse and use. So this is something that you really like. The quantity is 100 ml. It's very gentle on the skin. The fragrance is there, but it's not too overpowering. It's very, very mild and soothing to the skin. It's very calming and it does not strip your skin of its natural moisture cleansing, as you all can know, can be kind of like a stripping process for your face. So using cleansers like this that are mild at the same time that cleanses so well, it's very nice. I really really recommend this, and I'm going to purchase this face wash again once I'm done with all other face washes that I currently have in my bathroom. So this is something that I would 100% recommend. Now coming to the next step, which is the toning. My holy grail toner, of course, plum green tea toner. I have another backup of that, and I also got the other variant, chamomile one as well. This is my favorite toner. This has glycolic acid. If you're looking to start introducing acids and exfoliants into your skincare, and you're kind of wanting to do it very very slow, then you can definitely use this toner, because this has glycolic acid and it's a very nice way, gentle way to introduce exfoliants into your skincare routine. This is a beautiful toner. It does not irritate my skin, it calms my skin down. The only downside is that it has a little bit of an overpowering fragrance that some people might be sensitive to, some people might dislike, but it's a very nice gentle face. I mean, it's a very nice gentle toner that does not irritate my skin. It only calms my skin. This is my holy grail toner, and I will keep repurchasing that toner forever. And the next toner is this Kaya Purifying Toner. This also has AHA in it in the form of mandelic acid, and it says that it's for oily combination skin. Again, with this particular product, it has a little bit of an overpowering fragrance, but the performance of this product is so good. It kind of calms my skin down, I would say, and it's a very mild way of exfoliating your skin. Not that you'll be able to see a difference or anything, but it's gonna gently exfoliate your skin. It's a very nice toner, and I might repurchase this, I'm not too sure. And the other toner that I emptied out is from Good Vibes. This is the Avocado Clarifying Toner. This was like an okay toner. I really like the rose water variant in this particular Good Vibes range. That's like my favorite toner. This was okay. It's the only downside is that again it has fragrance and it has color in it. I do not understand why it has color. So that's something that I don't like about this toner, but overall it's a budget friendly okayish toner, I would say. Now coming to the next step, which is the moisturizer. This is the Simple Hydrating Light Moisturizer. Like you can see the state of my moisturizer. One thing I hate about this moisturizer is the packaging. I still have product inside this bottle, but I cannot get it out of this particular thing, and I'm not able to open this. It keeps like rotating and I'm not able to do it, and cutting it and using it up is like, I felt that it's like a huge mess. So I decided to toss this particular moisturizer. Overall, it's a very nice gel. It's kind of in between like a gel and a cream, and it's very lightweight on the skin. At the same time, it moisturizes my skin very very well. So I like this, but I will not repurchase this unless they change the packaging to a tube form or a pump form. I hate the packaging. We have one more moisturizer, but I forgot to talk to you about the serums that I emptied out. But anyways, let's finish up with the moisturizer. The next moisturizer that I emptied out is this one. This is the Garnier Winter Care Nourishing Cold Cream. It's a very nice thick cream. If you're a person with really really dry skin, and if your skin is combination, and even if it gets dry during winters or transition between seasons, then you can definitely purchase this. It's a very nice thick consistency, deeply nourishing cream, and it's a very nice cream for dry skin people. I really really like this. I might repurchase this, I'm not too sure. I have too many moisturizers at the moment to repurchase any other moisturizer. And let me finish up with these serums. So the first serum that I emptied out is this Jeva Vitamin C Serum. It's like an okay serum. This is the first ever Vitamin C Serum that I ever bought, and this was like very very cheap. It was like 350 rupees or something, and I feel that the Sugandha one does a better job. It has better ingredients than this one, so I would suggest you to go for the Sugandha one rather than going for this one. So this is like an okay Vitamin C Serum. And the next one is my favorite product from Sugandha. This is the Sugandha BHA 2% and salicylic acid centella and green tea serum. I have reviewed the entire Sugandha brand on my channel, and you can definitely go and check that out. It's a very nice serum. How I like to use it is as a spot treatment. Like you can see, if I have a spot right here, I like to use salicylic acid, not spot. If I have an acne or a pimple right there, active acne, then I like to treat it with this particular one drop of this particular serum, and it definitely helps. It's a very nice serum. At the moment I've purchased the COSRX one. I'm currently using that one, so I will repurchase this one. That once that gets over, I might repurchase this. I'm not too sure. Now talking about sunscreens, I have two sunscreens. Actually I have three, but two tubes of the same sunscreen. So this is the Neutrogena Ultra Sheer Dry Touch Sunblock. This is SPF 50. I have two small tubes of this. This is like an okay sunscreen. It's nice. But the thing is, I have moved towards physical sunscreen. I don't use chemical sunscreen anymore. I guess this is chemical sunscreen. Yeah, this must be chemical sunscreen. So I wouldn't be repurchasing this because I'm currently using a physical sunscreen that's from Earth Rhythm. I also switched between that and the Mama Earth one. Talking about the Mama Earth one, I completely emptied out one tube of this Mama Earth Ultra Light Indian Sunscreen. This actually has physical and chemical filters, but I guess titanium dioxide is way above in the ingredients list. So I guess majorly it's a physical sunscreen, and this does not irritate my skin. So I like using this sunscreen, and I already have a backup which I'm currently using. So it's a very nice sunscreen. Highly recommend this. Now coming to masks, I have emptied out my favorite mask. I would definitely repurchase this. This is the L'Oreal Pure Clay Mask Detoxify. I basically got this after looking at Shreya Jain's video, and she was talking about this, and she was saying that how it deeply cleanses her skin, and I wanted to try this out for myself. It was on a great offer, so I just decided to purchase it. And this is something that really made my skin very clear, and I feel that this deeply cleanses my skin, and I think I will definitely repurchase this. I'm currently using the Dot & Key clay mask thing, and I really like using this. It just pulls out all the gunk from my face and makes it very clear. So that's something that I really like. Next, moving on to lip balms, I emptied out these two lip balms. Both are from the same brand, same thing. It's the Nivea Original Care lip balm. I'll keep repurchasing this. It's a very nice lip balm. It's like a Vaseline in a tube form. It deeply nourishes my lips, and it keeps it very hydrated. This is actually my favorite lip balm. Now moving on to makeup, I have like three products to show you guys. The first one is this lash glue by Miss Claire. This is like an okay lash glue. It's good for beginners, but I prefer the pack lash glue over this. This turns goopy a little bit more easier than that one, so I don't prefer this. But it's not a bad lash glue. It's like an okay lash glue, budget friendly okay lash glue. So the next thing is this Essence eyeliner pen. This is actually, it does not perform that well right now. It's not like really smooth. It might seem like it has product in it, but it's not like really smooth and stuff, so I'm just throwing this away. It's a very nice dark eyeliner pen, and before I could use this to its full potential, it kind of dried up a little bit, so I'm just throwing this away. It's a very nice one, but I don't think I'll be repurchasing that one because I like using liquid eyeliners over those pen style eyeliners. The last one is my favorite concealer. This is the Maybelline Instant Age Rewind Dark Circle Eraser Concealer in the shade Caramel. I already have a backup of this. I love this. It's like completely gone, like it's completely empty. I can't get anything out of this. It's a very nice, good coverage, lightweight, super blendable concealer. All points check. I really like this concealer. Highly recommend this. So with that, we come to the end of this video. That was my mini review on all of the products that I emptied out in the recent past, and I hope you found this video useful, and I hope you liked it, or I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, please give this video a big thumbs up. Please share, comment, and also don't forget to subscribe to my channel. I'll see you next time in another interesting video. Until then, take care. Tata, bye bye.